Process Designer, CRUD Operations Using JDBC. The acronym CRUD stands for Create, Read, Update, and Delete. These are the four basic functions of persistent storage. In this video, we will see how to create a process for performing CRUD operations on a database. Before creating the process, let us see the connection and the object details that we will use in this video. Here, EA SQL Server is the connection. If the connection is not yet published, then publish it. In the metadata, we can see the list of tables available in the database. Employees is the object that we will use in the process. Let us now create a new process. Name the process and add an input for the type of CRUD operation. Depending on the input, the process continues to execute either in create, read, update, or delete paths. So, this input must be a required field. Add all the other fields needed for the process. Here, let us add ID and name. Add a decision step to choose the type of operation. Assign a value for the first path as C for create operation. Let us create a new record in the employees table. For this, add a create step and select the connection and the object. We can view the input and output fields associated with the object. In the input fields tab, add all the fields that we want to create in the table. Next, we need to observe the result. For this, in the start step, add an output field with the type same as that of the object. Then, using the assignment step, assign this output field. By following these steps, we were able to create new records in the table. Now let us add one more path for read operation. Create a new output field to store the query result for read operation. We will keep this variable type same as that of the object or the table name published in connection. Observe this option here, allow a list of objects of this type. This option allows us to store the list of records in this field. If we do not select this option, the query result will be truncated to a single record only. Next, let's add an assignment step to read the list data. Select the assignment type as query to make a database query. The from section is like the where clause of the query. If we leave it empty, the assignment step will read all records from table. Note that the query fetches only 100 records by default. If we have a greater number of records, after the required query, add limit followed by the number of records to fetch. For example, if we have 1000 records, under the from section, add limit 1000 at the end of the query condition. Also, we can add a condition if we want to read data of a specific ID. Note that if the table doesn't contain a primary key, it will fetch all the fields from the table. If the table has primary key, the assignment step will only fetch the primary keys or IDs from the table. Here, for our table, ID is the primary key. If we want to fetch any column other than the primary key or ID from the table, we can create another assignment step to fetch the required field for the respective ID. Let us fetch the name field of any selected employee and store it in a new output field. In this way, we can configure the read operation on the database. Now, let us add a new path in the decision step for the update operation. To perform the update operation, the table must have a primary key. If it has no primary keys, it will throw an error, object ID not specified. Updating any record is a two-step process. First, we must read the record to get the key value. Then, update the desired field of the fetched object. We will follow the similar process and create a field to store the record using the assignment step. Let's add a query condition to fetch the record that we want to update. And then add another assignment step to specify the field that we want to update. In this case, we are parameterizing the updated value to pass it at runtime. We can also hard code it with the help of content assignment. We can perform these steps whenever we want to update any record of a database. Finally, let's look at the delete operation. To perform a delete operation, we use a system service called delete object. Add a service step. In the service tab, select the service type as system service and the action as delete object. Observe that all the input fields are set to required. In the input fields tab, let us configure the properties. Specify the connection and the object names. Object ID is the ID of the object to be deleted. We can assign the value in two ways. Either use formula by selecting the ID, or add an assignment step to assign a specified object and then select the required field. Save and run the process. Let us check the response using the Postman application. Copy the service URL and paste it in Postman. Add the required query parameters. First, let us perform the create operation. Provide values for the parameters and send the request. Observe that the new record is generated. We can also verify the result in the database. Next, let's perform the read operation. Let's read the ID for the new record that was just created. Observe that the data is fetched. Similarly, we can perform update and delete operations. This is how we can perform CRUD operations on a database. So far, we have seen how to perform CRUD operations on a single record. Let us now see how to operate a list of records. There are many ways to perform this operation. One of them is to use the iteration rule property present in the sub-process step. For this demonstration, let us implement the logic using looping within a process. First, let us create a new process where we must update the salary of every employee by a certain amount. To update a record, we must have the employee ID. For this, let us create a temporary field to read the ID and then specify the type same as that of the object. Add the assignment step to assign the temporary field and give the value as a query to read all records. Now, add a decision step to check whether the list is empty and select the field. In this path, let us add a logic to update the record whenever it is sent. After updating that record, we will remove it from the list and then the rest of the records will be updated. This process continues till all the records are sent and the path becomes empty. Here, let us add a new temporary field to hold each record while updating. we will assign a value to this temporary field using the head function. The head function is used to obtain the first record of the list. Add an assignment step to update each record. We can specify the value that needs to be added to the salary. Here, we will use the formula to increment the salary. Now, let us remove the first record using the tail function. The tail function is used to remove the head, that is the first record, and returns the rest of the records. After removing the updated record, the rest of the records must be updated. For this, add a jump step to jump back to the decision step. This checks whether the list is empty and the process continues. After all the records are updated, the list completes and enters the empty path of the decision step. Now, let us add an output field to display the updated status when the list becomes empty. Save and run the process. In this way, we can create a similar process for create, read, and delete operations as well. We have therefore successfully performed CRUD operations on a list of data.